So let's get started with our topic, that is contouring. So we'll try to understand what is contouring and then what are the uses of contouring or a contour map, and then what shall be the characteristics that a contour map contain, what are the different methods by which you draw your contours. Those are the basic things that we will be covering under this contouring aspect. What does this word contouring means? So contouring is nothing but in a given area, we'll try to identify those points which has got same elevation from your mean sea level or from your datum. So on that surface of the ground, you might have some points which corresponds to the same elevation. Okay. And line joining the points of all those same elevation is what we call it as contour line. And such kind of contour lines what you draw for a given area or for a particular area, we call it as your contour map. Okay, so such contours whatever you are trying to draw for the given area and representing in the form of a map is what we call it as your contour map. So how is this contour line or contour map is prepared? So ultimately it is prepared based on what is called as your leveling. Okay, so in the case of leveling, what we do, we try to determine the levels at various points in the field. Okay, so all those points corresponding to the same elevation in that particular survey field, if I am trying to join them by means of a line, we call it as a contour line. And such contour lines, whatever we are trying to develop for that particular area, which is in turn represented in the form of a map, is what is called as a contour map. This is typically, let's say, area, the region, whatever I have. Okay, it's a hilly region, something. So for which I am trying to draw what is called as your contour map. So along that hill region, at some particular points when I am trying to identify, and let's say for example, this is my hill, assume. And along this hilly region, maybe at some points, if I try to pick out, I can understand that the elevation RL value of these certain points is same. And if I try to join them, all those points by means of a line, and that line, what I am representing in the plan view, look at here, this is the plan view what we are referring to. Okay, this is a plan. So if that line, whatever I am trying to join corresponding to the same elevations in the plan, if I am representing it, so that line is what we call it as your contour line. This is what is one of the contour line. This is another contour line. This is another contour line. And this is another contour line, and so on. Okay. So such lines are called as contour lines, and representation of all such contour lines in the form of a map is what we call it as contour map. Yeah. So what is meant by a contour line? Contour line may be defined as an imaginary line passing through points of equal RLs. Okay. So if I have some points corresponding to the same equal reduced levels or equal elevation points. So if I'm assuming that I am joining all those points by means of a line, so such line is what we call it as your contour line. Okay. So whenever you look any particular contour map, let's say, for example, I'm saying this is one contour line, this is another contour line, this is another contour line, and here is another contour line. Okay. So any contour line that you look at is represented with some RL value. Let's say the RL value of this contour line is something 90 meters. This RL value of this contour map is 80 meters. Contour line is 80 meters. This one, let's say 70 meters. This one, let's say some 75 meters. Okay. So it need not be continuously increasing or decreasing. Okay. It can be random, but we have some certain characteristics which a contour map, what we are going to be preparing, generally satisfy. So that we'll try to talk about a little later. So now if I'm looking this contour line, which has got the RL value 90 meters, what does it mean? Any point in this, on this particular contour line, if you are trying to determine the elevation, so the elevation of any point on that particular contour line with reference to your datum comes out to be equal to 90 meters. That is what is called as your contour line. So contour line is nothing but it's a line joining the imaginary points corresponding to the same RL value. Such line is what is called as your contour line. Likewise, another contour line, this corresponding to an RL value of 80 meters. So any point on this particular contour line, RL value is going to be, RL value of any of those points is nothing but simply equal to 80 meters. Okay, let's say for typical example, this is some hill which you have got here in this picture. And for this hill region, if you are trying to draw the contour, so what you could see is that top region of the hill, you have some points which you are trying to connect them. and you see that, okay, some point here, some point here, some point here, some point here, some point here. If I'm trying to join them in the form of a line, I'll be getting what is called as a contour line. Look at here. The same projection of all those points are very much clearly indicated. Okay. So top portion contour line is something like this. Something slightly below, its contour line is something like this. Something further below, its contour line is something like this. Okay. Further below, you have another contour line. So I'm trying to talk about drawing a contour line corresponding to different elevations. Okay. So if I consider this to be the base level or the zeroth elevation point, and at different levels, simply let's understand, I'm cutting this bottle to this height, and that surface, whatever I could see corresponding to all same contour points. So that surface is nothing but your region, what is getting formed in between your contour line, that closed region, whatever you could see is nothing but it is your contour line, which is forming that particular surface in the plan view. Okay. So that's how typically your contour map looks like in the case of a hill. And what you observe here is, when you are trying to talk about a contour map for the case of a hill, the contour lines, whatever you have on the outer of your contour map, let's say, for example, this is one of that contour line, what I am looking at. Okay. This contour line has got the RL value, which is equal to zero. Whereas this contour line has got the RL value, which is equal to 500. This contour map, contour line has got the RL value, which is equal to 1000. And all those units, let's say, for example, they are in feet. Okay. And another contour line, which has got the RL value, which is equal to 1500 feet. Another contour line, which has got the RL value, which is 2000 feet. So what is it indicating? So what I understand from this is, the contour line, which is there towards the inner region of the contour map. I repeat, the contour line. Okay. So this smaller one, whatever you see here, the contour line, which is there towards the inner region of the contour map. So that contour line corresponds to a higher elevation. And whereas the contour lines corresponding to the outer corresponds to your lower or the least elevation values. If you look at here in this contour map, the last contour line, the outermost contour line, has got the RL value, which is equal to zero. Okay. So where is that points existing then? Exactly at that base, whatever you are referring as your data. So at that base, all those respective points which has got your RL value, which is equal to zero. If I'm trying to join all those points, and the representation of that joint line in the plan view is nothing but representing a kind of a circle there. Okay. So that such kind of representation of a contour map, where higher elevations are inside your contour map and lower elevations are onto the outside of your contour map, it indicates that that particular contour map is for a kind of a hill. Okay. It's for a kind of a hill. Now look at here in this particular contour map itself, whatever we are trying to represent in this contour map itself, in some region, you could see the contour lines are relatively closer onto the left side of that particular contour map. The contour map, contour lines are relatively closer to each other. But whereas on the right side, if you look at that particular contour map, I am talking about the same contour map. Okay, if I consider this to be the center, onto this right side, the spacing between one contour to the other contour line, one contour line to the next contour line in the plan view, spacing is bigger. But whereas onto the left side, the spacing relatively, what I see between two successive contour lines, is smaller. What is it indicating? Okay, when do I come across with that smaller spacing? When do I come across with larger spacing? Whenever the slope of that particular ground, I repeat, whenever the slope of that particular ground, look at this hill, whatever we are referring to. Okay, this is that hill what we are referring to. Now, how is the slope onto the left side of the hill? How is the slope onto the right side of the hill? Onto the left side of the hill, the slope, whatever I am trying to represent, is relatively steeper slope. Onto the right side of your hill, the slope, whatever I have, is relatively flatter slope. Whenever the slope of the ground is relatively flat, in the plan view, the distance between one contour line to the next contour line is going to be relatively more. When the slope is steeper, the distance between one contour line to the next adjacent contour line in the plan, when you are looking at, is going to be relatively smaller distance. Okay, so here I am going to be talking about two terms. One is contour interval, other is horizontal equivalent. Now, what is contour interval? Contour interval is nothing but, it is the difference in elevation between one contour line to the next contour line. I repeat, contour interval is nothing but difference in elevation between one contour line to the next contour line is what we call it as contour interval. Okay, so what is contour interval here in the sense? Okay, so one contour line has got, outermost contour line what is drawn has got your RL value which is 0 feet. Next inner contour line has got your RL value which is 500 feet. Subsequently, next another inner contour line has got the RL value 1000 feet and so on. Now, what is the difference between 0 to 500 or 500 to 1000, 1000 to 1500 or 1500 to 2000? So, the difference in that RL values between two successive contour lines, difference in elevations what are represented corresponding to two successive contour lines is what is called as contour interval. In this particular example, the contour interval is 500 feet. Because one contour line has got elevation value of 0, another contour line has got the elevation value of 500, another contour line has got the elevation of 1000. So difference in elevation between two successive contour lines is what is called as your contour interval. In a given map, we prefer to choose a contour interval value which is constant. For the complete contour map, what we are trying to draw for a particular area, okay, for a particular region, that contour map what you are going to be preparing will be certainly prepared in most of the cases considering a constant contour interval for the complete map. Okay, now what is meant by horizontal equivalent? Horizontal equivalent, or sometimes I think we also refer it as horizontal gradient. Now, what does this horizontal equivalent means? If you look at here, I told you, onto one side in the plan view of your contour map, onto one side, the spacing between one contour line to the next contour line is relatively a smaller spacing. But when it comes to the right side region of your contour map in the plan, the spacing between two successive contour lines is relatively bigger, though it is for similar variation in the elevations. But however, what you see is, let's say, for example, I'm just drawing here. This is one contour line. Here is another contour line. Here is another contour line. Here is another contour line. Look at here. If I take this as my center of that particular region for which I have drawn my contour map. Okay, so here distance between this point to this point, let's say x, and once again I am looking between these two same contours, or let me consider another set of contours. Let's say the distance between this contour to this contour, let's say something x1, I am considering the same two contours, but on the other side what I see is that the distance is something y1, let's say. Now, is that x1 distance and y1 distance are they same? No, not exactly. Why they are not same? Because on one side, the slope of the ground is something different from the slope of the ground on the other side. Wherever the slope of the ground is relatively flat, the spacing between one contour line to the next contour line on that particular side is more in the plan when I see it. And on to the other side of your contour line, where you have a steeper slope, the distance between two contour lines in the plan view is relatively very small distance between those two represented contour lines in the plan. Okay, so that x1 or y1 distance, whatever we are trying to refer to, is nothing but is what we call it as horizontal equivalent. Okay, so I repeat that x1 distance or y1 distance, whatever we are seeing, is nothing but is what we call it as horizontal equivalent. Okay, look at this particular picture. Let me erase this unnecessary data, whatever we have got. Yeah, so in this if I am trying to look at what are the points which I am trying to highlight. Okay, so the distance between these two, what is represented, our distance between these two, are the distance between these two. Okay, so this distance or this distance or this distance is nothing but we call it as horizontal equivalent. Okay, and the distance between these two, that means this distance or this distance or this distance. Okay, so these are nothing but we call it as your contour interval. So understand the difference. In the elevation direction, if I am looking at the difference in elevation between one contour line to the next contour line, so that is nothing but contour interval. In the horizontal direction, how the variation is happening, okay, and the distance between one reference contour line to the next contour line in the plan view, if you are understanding the distance between them in the horizontal direction, so that is what we call it as horizontal equivalent. And the horizontal equivalent may not be same for a given contour map. In that particular contour map, when you are drawing your contour lines, so horizontal equivalent, what you are trying to talk about, may not be same. But whereas your contour interval, what you are trying to talk about with reference to your vertical interval, okay, so that is most of the times considered to be same. Why horizontal equivalent is not same? Because on one direction the spacing between the same two contour lines is more, onto other side the spacing between the same two contour lines is relatively small. So that horizontal equivalent value is not going to be same everywhere in that particular contour map. That's what I mean to say. And whenever you look at the representation of a contour map, okay, let's say this is some typical representation of a contour map. This is your contour map, what we are trying to talk about. Now if you look at here, let's say this is one contour line, this is another, this is the other one, this is the other one, this is the other one, and another contour line. Once again, I have got. Okay. So if you identify those contour lines, for every five contour lines, let's say for example, I'm starting from here. This is first contour line, second, third, fourth, fifth, and sixth. For every five successive contour lines, you are representing your contour line with relatively thicker representation. The line, whatever you are drawing, is by a solid representation. Solid line is what you are representing there. Not a very thinner line. It's a thick line what you are indicating. Okay. So why is that specifically you are indicating that thick line means? Just to give you a difference in your contour map, that for every five successive contour lines, if first contour line is indicated with a dark line, then sixth contour line will be again indicated with the dark line. 11th contour line will be again indicated with the dark line. So every five successive contour lines, whatever you have, so that every fifth contour line is indicated with a thick line representation. Just only for you to give an idea, whenever you are looking at a contour map, it is difficult for everyone to understand how many contour lines are there, how is the elevation difference, and so on. So as like in the case of a chain, when we have talked about a chain, for every 1 meter you have a small link, for every 3 meters you have another, for every 5 meters you have another type of special link with one teeth, two teeth, three teeth, and so on. So what is the purpose of those? You need not go to each of the link to understand how many centimeters is there from one point to the other point. So you can place your chain, and if that chain is extended to one teeth link, it means directly 5 meters. Two teeth link, 10 meters. Three teeth link, 15 meters. So likewise, it makes your life comfortable. Even in the case of your contour map also, every five successive, after every fifth contour line, you represent that particular contour line by a thick line representation. So which would make your life comfortable in understanding how many contour lines are there, how the elevation of each of the contour line is varying, and so on. So what is meant by contour interval? The vertical distance between two consecutive contours is nothing but we are calling it as contour interval. So already I have talked about what is that contour interval, how do we understand the value of the contour interval and so on. Now, what are the various factors based on which this particular contour interval basically depends on? Okay. So in general, whenever you are trying to choose what shall be the contour interval for a particular contour map, so contour interval, whatever we are going to be choosing, basically depends on the nature of the ground. That means whether the ground is a flat ground, whether the ground is a steep ground, or so on. And it also depends on the scale of the map, whatever you are choosing. Whether you are choosing the scale of 1 centimeter is equal to 1 meter, or 1 centimeter is equal to 100 meters, 1 centimeter is equal to 10 meters. So it depends on the scale of the map what you have chosen. That means whether you are carrying out your contouring for relatively a large area, whether you are carrying out your contouring relatively for a small area. So depending on that, your contour interval, what you are going to be choosing, would also be depending. And the purpose of the survey, okay? So whatever the contour interval that you are going to be choosing would also even depend on the purpose of the survey that you are carrying out. So for what purpose you are carrying out that particular survey? So whether you are carrying out that contouring survey for construction of a reservoir, or for construction of a railway track, or for construction of a road, or for construction of a canal. So for what purpose? So depending on that also, your contour interval that you are going to be choosing depends on. Okay. If it is the construction of an embankment, area over which that embankment is being constructed is relatively a small area. If it is a reservoir, it is relatively small area when compared to that of the area what you come across in terms of your railway track. Okay, so depending on that region, depending on your type of purpose for which you are carrying out that survey to develop your contour map, you are going to be choosing your respective contour interval. So if you look at here, typically this is one contour line, this is one contour map, this is another contour map. What difference that this contour map and this contour map has got means, here in this case it's a hill, and the other case also it is a hill, but the right side hill is relatively having a flatter slope when compared to that of this left side hill portion, whatever you see here. So as the slope is relatively flatter, so the contour interval, whatever you are going to be choosing, would be different in this particular case to that of the other case, or according to your convenience. It's all about according to your convenience. It's not compulsory that you have to choose this much contour interval and so on. Okay. So this is another case of a contour map. Depending on your necessity, you are choosing what is to be your contour interval for representing that particular contours in the form of a map. So that vertical elevation difference, whatever you see in that sectional view, so that what a vertical elevation difference is what we are calling it as your contour interval. So contour intervals for flat ground are generally small, whereas the contour intervals relatively for a steeper slope in the case of hilly area is relatively chosen with a bigger value. So it's self-explanatory, like whatever we are referring to. So in the case of flat grounds, the variation of elevation between one level to the other level is not very much high. So there, in such cases, we relatively go for what is called as smaller contour interval for representing the contour map of that region. But when it comes to the steeper slope, then for representing that particular area which has got the steeper sloping region or a hilly area, so in such case, the contour interval what we choose is relatively high, like 5 meters, 10 meters, 15 meters. So depending on your necessity of that particular problem, what you are dealing with. And even depending on the scale of the map, what you are choosing, okay? So depending on the scale of the map, whatever you are choosing, as I told you, your contour interval would be depending on, okay? So contour interval is kept large, up to 2 meters for projects such as highways and railways, because that area over which, when I am talking about highways and railways, the variation in elevations could be relatively large from one region to that of the other region. So in such cases, we choose to go for what is called as a relevant contour interval value, which is high. But when it comes to relatively smaller area, like for a building, for construction of a dam, for an earthen embankment or something like that, so the area what we are concentrating is relatively less, the variation in the elevations in that smaller area could be also relatively less. So that's the reason why we go on to choose contour interval value relatively small. And next, it is desirable to have a constant contour interval for a particular map. So it's not compulsory that a given contour map should have same contour interval value for the complete map. But whenever you are going to construct your contour map, for making our life simple, we try to choose the contour interval in a such a way that it is going to be constant for the complete contour map what you are constructing. Yeah. So horizontal equivalent means, what does it mean? Already I have talked about. So the horizontal distance between any two consecutive contours. Okay. So that horizontal distance between any two consecutive contours is nothing but it is called as your horizontal equivalent. And already I have told you, this horizontal equivalent value is not going to be constant for the complete contour map. Or in between two consecutive contour lines itself, that horizontal equivalent value is not going to be same, because in one place it could be something, in other place it could be something else, it could be something else at some other place also. Okay, so your horizontal equivalent value, which you are trying to calculate, considering two successive contour lines, that horizontal equivalent value is not going to be same, even for that considered two consecutive contours. It varies from point to point depending on the steepness of the ground. Steeper the ground, lesser is going to be your horizontal equivalent. So when you have a steeper ground, that horizontal distance between two contour lines, as I was showing you earlier, let's look at here, these two. Okay, so the horizontal distance between these two contour lines on towards the steeper side is very less when compared to that of the horizontal distance that you have got between the same two contour lines onto some other side. Okay, so towards the steeper side, the horizontal equivalent value is relatively less. Towards your flatter sloping side, your horizontal equivalent value is relatively large. Now moving on to understand, what are the uses of your contour map? Why do I require a contour map? From a given contour map, what is that I am going to understand? How do I make use of a contour map? So that is what let us try to understand. Contour maps provide valuable information about the topography of the area, whether that particular area is flat, whether the particular area is undulating, or whether it is containing some mountainous regions, whether it is containing some valley region, or simultaneously mountains and valleys. So how is that particular area? If I want to understand that, I can understand by looking at the contour map of that particular region. The nature of the ground surface of an area can be understood by studying a contour map. So how is the nature of that particular ground? Okay, whether it is undulated, whether it is containing some very steep hill surfaces, or whether it has got flat hill surfaces, whether it is containing some valley region, what is it? All that I can try to study from that particular contour map, and I can understand the basic topography conditions of that particular location. Even without going there also, if I have what is the contour map of that particular region, by looking at it, I can get some basic understanding about that particular construction site, or I can get some basic information about that particular site what I am trying to look at. The following are the specific uses that we come across in the case of your contour map. So what are those basic uses that we have got with your contour map? To select site for engineering projects such as roads, canals, railways, and so on. So in the process of designing a proper road network between one place to the other place, or in proper design of canals, just by the effect of gravity, how the flow can happen from one point to the other point. If I want to go on to construct a railway track between two places to be connected. So all that I can try to understand by looking at your contour map, so that I can just look at how the ground profile is varying between those two points in between which I want to construct your railway track, or in between which I want to construct your road. How is the ground, whether it is undulated, whether it is uneven. So if it is uneven, then in some places I might be requiring to cut the ground, that means excavating the ground to construct your pavement or road. In some places, you might have some valley regions where you will be required to fill the soil there in that particular region to have your road constructed. So all that information basically we'll be able to get from your contour map. And your contour map is also useful to find the possible route of communication between two places, like construction of roadway or construction of a railway and so on. And this contour map is also useful for us to estimate the capacity of a reservoir, or maybe which is that particular area which is going to get submerged whenever there is floods. Okay, so all that information, because from the contour map I can understand which is that particular region which has got lower elevation. Okay, so in that lower elevation I can go on to understand how much is that region which is going to get affected because of the submergence due to the floods. If somebody asks you to construct a reservoir in particular location, now what could be the volume of the water which can be catched there, or how much could be the volume of that catchment region? Okay, that all I can try to calculate if at all I am required to construct any dam, or if I am required to construct any reservoir or any water storage body, and so on. To ascertain the profile of the ground surface along any direction. So how is the ground profile varying in any particular direction between some points, if I want to understand, by looking at your contour map, I can try to understand. And I can also understand what could be the suitable area for a given gradient can be marked on that particular map. So if I want to design a proper canal with a proper slope, so what could be the possible direction in which I can try to design that canal with a proper gradient, because you should not have more slope for a canal at some place and lesser slope for a canal at some other place. If the slope is more, the velocity with which the flow is going to be more. If the velocity is more, there is a possibility of scouring taking place, or there could be a possibility of due to that excess higher velocity with which the flow is happening, there is a possibility of soil erosion or some other difficulties we might be coming across. So to avoid all that, proper gradient you have to understand by which you can align your canal, and accordingly you can design that particular canal for its construction. And the contour maps are also useful for estimating the quantity of cutting and filling. As like I have told you, if I am required to construct a pavement, a road from one point to the other point, somewhere you might come across with some higher elevated region, somewhere you might have come across with lower elevated regions. The ground may not be completely flat according to your requirement. Somewhere you might have some higher elevated ground, somewhere you might have lower elevated ground. So depending on your necessity, in some regions you might be required to excavate the soil, in some regions you might be required to fill the soil, so that you get a proper ground as per your necessity of construction. So ultimately this contour maps will also be helpful for us in estimating how much should be the quantity of soil that is to be excavated, or how much amount of soil that has to be filled in that particular region, so that you can take up the required type of construction. And it is also useful for the contour map is also useful for us to know the drainage characteristics of that particular area. Drainage characteristics in the sense, if there is a flooding, then what is the direction in which the floods or excess water, in which direction it will be flowing because of that flooding, or because of that excess runoff during the rainfall season. So in which is that region which is going to be affected? Okay, so what would be the direction in which the water will be flowing? So all that drainage characteristics of that particular area can be very much easily understood by looking at your contour map. Now, what are the different characteristics that your contour would have? Okay, so your so-called contours that you are representing in the contour map, what different characteristics it generally show you? Since every point on a contour line has the same elevation, a contour map with a constant interval portrays the conformation. This is not conformation, it is the conformation of the ground in a characteristics manner. So looking at that particular contour line, what that contour map is containing, so it is going to give you some information. Okay, so what kind of information that I get from that particular contour? So that information is what we call it as your characteristics of your contour. Okay, the knowledge of contour characteristics helps in identifying the natural features of that particular area from the given map, and in avoiding mistakes in plotting the contours correctly. This is some contour map what you can look at here. Okay, this is some contour map, and you could see some path what is that you are trying to mark between these two points. Okay, so in between these two points you want to construct what is called as a road. So in the process of constructing the road from one point to the other point, I'm just trying to know, okay, the elevation of this particular region is something 1604 meters, are maybe 1604 feet, and the elevation of this particular region is something 1717 feet. So how that particular two points are to be connected? So in which parts of the region you need to be going for cutting? In which parts of the region you will be going for filling? Or whether that route what you have chosen between those two points is proper to go in the straight path, or you have to take your road from one direction to the other direction depending on your convenience? Because constructing a road doesn't mean that you are going to be laying down the road between two points in the shortest path. Okay, so you should also be seeing for other aspects of it. Let's say, for example, the distance between these two points, 1604 feet elevation point and 1717 feet elevation point, shortest distance is something here to here. But however, in this region, if I have some water body, maybe a pond or maybe a lake or something, if it is existing, is it feasible to go on to construct a road through that particular region? It doesn't make sense in going on to construct a road through that particular region, because if I am required to construct a road through that region where you have your water body, I have to go on to construct a bridge. Is it feasible in terms of the economical aspect? All that I have to understand, and accordingly I have to choose the alignment of that particular road by knowing the information from that particular contour map. So certain following characteristics that we get on to know from your contour line and subsequent contour map. Okay, so the following characteristics generally help in plotting or reading any information from a map. Okay, all the points on a contour line have the same elevation, that's sure. The elevations of the contour are indicated either by inserting the figure in a break or in respective contour are printed close to the contour. So whenever you are representing a contour line in the contour map, you'll be representing, let's say this is my contour line, if I'm saying. So adjacent to this contour line, you'll be writing something, let's say 155 meters. What does it mean? The elevation of this particular contour line is nothing but it is 155 meters. So this representation of 155, whatever you have indicated adjacent to your contour line or on your contour line or within that closed region of the contour line, so is giving you the information regarding the RL value of that particular contour line. Two contour lines do not intersect with each other. Whenever you look at a contour map, two contour lines will not generally intersect each other. Okay, that's how I should have it in my mind while constructing your contour lines and subsequently construction of the in the preparation of your contour map. In case if you are getting a condition where two contour lines are intersecting each other, it means that you are somewhere there is an issue with your contour map, whatever you are trying to plot. Sir, how come you say your two contour lines are not going to intersect each other? Let's say, for example, this is one contour line, and if I say this is another contour line, is there a possibility? Look at here. What is this I am indicating? I am indicating a point. I repeat, I am indicating a point corresponding to one contour line, and I am indicating the point on the other contour line also, because this point, what I am indicating, let's say point A, is said to be the intersection point of your contour line 1 and contour line 2. What did we say regarding a contour line? Contour line is nothing but a line joining the points of equal elevation. Now, can you have a point on the ground which has got two different elevations? I repeat, can you have a point on the ground which has got two different elevations? Okay, so it's not possible. So that's the reason why we say two contour lines will not intersect each other. So this is not correct to indicate that two contour lines are intersecting each other. Contour lines always, this is not from form. Okay, so contour lines always form a closed circuit. So what does this closed circuit means? Whenever you are trying to talk about a contour map for a particular region, let's say this is my contour map, what I am trying to prepare. So contour map, whatever we are trying to look at, will contain the contour lines which will be getting closed like this. Okay, you are not going to have a contour line just like that drawn. something like a line. In case if you look at a contour map which is not having what is called as a closed shape, it doesn't mean that it is not a proper contour map. Still it is called as a proper contour map, but however, that so-called contour line which is not getting closed may not be getting closed in that particular region of the map for which you have drawn. It might be getting closed beyond some region of your contour map, whatever you have drawn for that particular area. So that is what you should be understanding. Generally, your contour lines, whatever you are going to be representing, are going to be like a closed circuit. It will have the starting point, and the ending point of that particular contour line would also be at the starting point of that contour line, what you have started with. So it looks like a closed circuit. But whenever you look at your contour maps, always you may not be seeing only your closed circuit types of contour lines indicated. Okay, just what does it mean? What is that I am trying to talk about? Okay, look at here. Typically, here in this case, yeah, just see what is that I am highlighting towards the center of your contour map. Here, this contour line, I could see that it is getting closed. It is in the form of a closed circuit. But I have got some other contour lines. I don't know where is the starting of that contour line, where is the ending represented for that particular contour line. Maybe let's look at some contour line here. Okay, so I have some contour line going like this. I repeat, some contour line going like this. Is it looking like a closed curve? No. Okay, in that particular given contour map region, I am not looking it as a closed curve, but however, beyond that, for beyond that particular region, if I am trying to look at the area to further understand how that particular contour line is going to be, so I might be getting my contour line something like this beyond this particular region, and it might be getting close like this. Okay, so it doesn't mean that your contour, whatever you are trying to talk about, it should be a closed circuit. It need not be within that particular contour map. It can be beyond your region of that particular contour map, what you have prepared. But however, mostly it will be like what is called as your closed circuit formation. Contours do not have sharp turnings. So whenever you are trying to draw your contour lines, so you will not have sharp turnings whenever you are indicating a contour line. Contour lines are closer, nearer the top of a hill or wherever you have your high ground, and wide apart near the foot. Okay. So in such case, your contour lines are going to be closer, nearer to the top of a hill, and far away indication of the contour lines. Look at here. Towards the top, I could see that your contour lines are relatively closer. Towards the bottom of that hill, contour lines could be relatively far away. Okay, so that's what it means. So far away indicates it is a flatter slope towards the bottom and steeper slope towards your top. That's how that's a reason that's a reason why the variation of that particular contour lines are like that. The contour lines are closer, nearer the bank of a pond or depression, and wide towards the center. So why is that contour lines are closer, nearer the bank, and why they are relatively spread apart in the case of your center? Because towards the banks, towards the end of your pond or towards the ends of your embankment or banks of that particular river region or so on, you will have relatively the slope of that particular bank which is steeper in nature. But when it comes to the center region of that particular pond, what you will see is that the ground relatively flatter in nature. If the ground is relatively flatter in nature, then your contour lines, what you are going to be drawing for that flatter region, would be spread relatively, they are not going to be close to each other, they are far away. One contour line and another contour line will be relatively far away from each other, because the elevation difference between one point to the other point is not much higher in the case of that flatter region. But when it comes to that of steeper region, at the banks of your river or at the banks of your pond or so on, you have a kind of a vertical excavation there, or a vertical slope of the ground existing. So that's the reason why towards the banks of your pond or banks of the river, you will have your contour lines existing very much closer to each other in the representation of your contour map. But when it comes to the center region of the pond, or maybe towards your center region of your river flowing region, so you will have your contour lines relatively represented far away from each other. That's what it is. Uniformly spaced contour, uniformly spaced contours or contour lines indicate a uniform slope ground. Okay, so what does this uniformly spaced contour indicate means? Let's say, for example, I have one contour line like this, another contour line like this, another contour line like this, another contour line like this. So what I see is that one contour line to the next contour line, that contour line to the next contour line, the horizontal equivalent value is not very much high. More or less, it's a same horizontal equivalent what you are looking at. So distance between these two points, our distance between these two points, our distance between these two points, more or less they are same. So in the cases where your ground is relatively a flat slope or with a uniform slope, you are going to see that your contour lines are spaced uniformly with one another. So whenever you come across with uniformly spaced contours, that generally indicates what is called as a uniform slope of that particular ground. Okay, these are typical cases of contour maps that we are going to be coming across with. Maybe here we could see what is called as a uniformly sloping ground of that particular hilly region, or maybe here the slope is relatively flat in this particular contour map because the distance between one contour line to the next contour line is relatively more, so which indicates that it is the slope of that ground is relatively flat in nature. If you look at some of those contour lines here in this particular case, the contour lines are represented closer to one another, indicating that the ground or that particular profile of the ground is having a relatively steeper nature of slope. And if you look at a contour map here in this particular region, what we understand is that this particular shape, whatever we are getting, is indicating a kind of a stream. Stream is nothing but the region through which the water flowing. It's the area of your water flowing. Okay, so in that particular region, that's how the shape of your contour line, how is it going to be? And in the case of your hilly region, towards the peak of that hilly region, you'll have what is called as this cross section, something like this, which we call it as a ridge. Okay, so in the case of your valley region, the shape of your contour line would come out to be something like this. Look at here. Either like this or either like this. It depends on the slope of that particular valley. Okay, so it totally depends on the how the ground is, how your profile of the ground is. Depending on that, the shape of your contour lines would also accordingly be coming. Now, in this particular case of the contour map, if you see, this region indicates one stream path. This region indicates another stream path. Now, what does this say? You have two different like streams of water bodies getting intersected at some point. Let's say if you have one river coming from this direction, another river coming from this direction, wherever you have the intersection of these two, okay, so that intersection of those two is what is indicated here, okay, in this region. And this line, this direction is what I am calling it as one stream. Stream is nothing but the region in which the water is flowing. This is another stream, the direction in which the water is flowing. Okay, so that streams are indicated by the contour lines, which would have some shapes like this. You'd be having your contour lines if you are drawing for that particular region. You'll be getting some kind of shapes like this. Okay, so typically, depending on the condition of the ground there, depending on the information what that particular ground has, like any water flowing region or maybe a hilly region, maybe a valley region, or what type of the ground, how is it existing, so all that information would be understood from your typical contours or contour maps, whatever we are going to be representing. This is something interesting. Look at this contour map. Okay, this contour map. Now, if you look at that particular contour map, you could see that the contour lines are something like this. Okay, so this total is what I am calling it as my contour map. If you can see there, you have four kind of loops. One loop coming from this side, another loop coming from this side, another loop coming from this side, another loop coming from this side. So such kind of four loops representation, what is it indicating me? In the sense, it is what is called as saddle. Now, what does this saddle means? Now, if I am looking at that particular region or in that particular region for which you have a saddle shape of contour map, so what is it going to indicate you means? From one side you have your hill coming, other side also you have your hill coming, whereas onto these two sides you have your valley regions existing. Okay, so from these two sides it is hilly regions, and onto the other side, if I am looking at it, is your valley region. It's a low elevation, and this side it's an increase in elevation. Okay, so such kind of region or an impression or that area what is getting formed. Okay, is what we call it as a saddle. Okay, such representation of your contour contour lines with contours closing towards in the opposite direction in one case, where the elevations of these contour lines will be increasing to each other in one case, decreasing away from each other in the other case, where decreasing indicates your hilly regions, increasing towards the center of that contour map indicates it is a valley region. So all that we have to clearly understand. So all that whatever we are trying to talk about is represented in the form of a table here, like the specific characteristics or the rules that a contour line would be satisfying or would be considered when you are representing them. Yeah, so towards the steeper slope, whatever the examples that we are trying to talk about in this case, towards the steeper slope, the contour lines are relatively indicated closer to each other. Towards the gentle slope or the flatter slope, we see that the contour lines are represented or spaced at a far away distances. Okay, if I typically look at this particular contour map, what is indicated? So this area of the ground indicates it's an undulation, it's a depression in the ground, and in this region it indicates it's a higher elevation of the ground. Here also higher elevation relatively when compared to this depression, and on the other side it is once again a depression in the ground. Depression in the sense a kind of a lower elevation existing. Now if I look at how my typical contour map is looking like, so this closed contour lines, whatever you have here represented, indicates you what? They basically indicates you what is called as depression. So typically, whenever you have your contour line indicated for representing a depression region, so it's not just simply represented by drawing a curve like this, but we'll also be indicating some lines on that particular curve just to distinguish that so-called closed contour line, whatever you have drawn, closed contour circuit, whatever you have drawn, is indicating you a depression region. It's a lower elevation region in that particular area. In that particular region, within that region, that small portion is indicating you a kind of a valley or a lower elevated ground profile. And here, when you are trying to look at this particular contour map, some information what we can understand from this contour map is, look at here. This contour line has got an elevation 290. This contour line has got an elevation 300. This contour line has got an elevation 310, 320, 330, and so on. But whereas on the other side, when you are looking at, this contour line has got 290 meters, 300, and once again, another contour line with the same elevation 300 have got another contour line with 290 meters elevation, 280 meters elevation, and so on. What is it happening? When there is no repetition of the same RL values of the contour line, we call such contour lines are non-repeating contour lines. But whereas here in this region, what I could see is 300, 300, 290, 290. What is that? I have one contour line with same 290 meters elevation, another contour line also with the same 290 meter elevation. Okay, there is one contour line with 300 meter elevation, another contour line with 300 meter elevation. So such kind of contour lines, what you are indicating with the same elevation, are what is called as repeat contour lines. I repeat. Okay, so such kind of contour lines whose contour interval is getting whose elevation is same, so such represented contour lines are what is called as your repeat contour lines. When there is no same elevation of the contour line coming into picture, then such contour lines are called as your non-repeating contour lines. A series of closed contour always indicate a depression or summit. Summit or depression is nothing but it's a region which is relatively with a lower elevation, and it's a kind of a small region within which the elevations are relatively low. The low values being inside the loop, the lower elevation, when you are trying to draw the contour for a valley, let's say for example, this is how is my ground. Okay, this is how is the ground. Now for this particular ground, if I am trying to draw my contour map, so what would happen of this particular elevation, all the points corresponding to this particular elevation, if I join them and if I indicate them in the contour map, I'll be getting, let's say, some contour line. Maybe at this elevation, if I am joining the respective points and if I am trying to draw another contour line, I'll be getting another contour line like this. Likewise for another elevation, I'll be getting another contour line. For some other elevation, I'll be getting another contour line like this. Now, when you are looking at the contour lines, what you are representing, the contour line which is there inside towards the center of the contour map, this contour line RL value is less. It means, let's say, for example, RL is equal to some 30 meters for this case, whereas it is 40 meters for this case, 50 meters for this case, 60 meters for this case, and so on. So what is it indicating? Whenever you come across with a depression or a kind of a valley region, okay, so the RL value of the contour line towards the inner region of the contour map, the RL value is lower, and as you move on to the outer contour lines, the RL value is going to be increasing. That is for sure, because towards the center of that region, you have valley elevation of that valley from the reference datum is going to be at a lower elevation. Okay, the point towards the bottom of the valley is at a lower elevation from your datum. So that's the reason why the contour line what you draw towards the bottom portion of your valley will have a lesser RL value when compared to that of the contour lines which are drawn for other higher elevated grounds. Okay. When it comes to the case of your hilly region, if this is my hill what I am looking at, for this particular region, if I am trying to draw my contour map for this particular elevation, okay, so these points, if I'm just trying to extend it and to understand in the plan how my contour map is going to be looking like, let's say this is typically my contour map for this particular elevation. So what is this elevation? Is it a higher elevation or lower elevation when compared to the other peak points of your hill? Obviously it is a lower elevation. So I can say, let's say this RL is something 100 meters. I'm just roughly considering some numbers. Now, if I'm trying to draw the contour for this particular elevation, so these points, if I'm just trying to project it onto my the plan view, so maybe this region indicates you another contour line, whereas the RL value of this contour line is obviously greater than that of 100 meters. Let's say something 110 meters. If I'm choosing a contour interval of 10 meters, so RL value of the inner contour line is going to be higher because I'm moving towards your higher elevated ground there. So furthermore, further higher RL value, let's say it is some 120 meters, likewise 130 meters. So what is happening in the case of a valley? Okay, so what we see is that the RL values of your contour lines will decrease towards the center of your contour map, and whereas in the case of a hill, the RL values of the contour lines will increase towards the center of your contour map. Okay, so that's very important for us to understand. Yeah, a series of closed contour always indicates a depression or summit. The lower values being inside the loop indicates a depression, and higher values being inside the loop indicate a summit. Summit is nothing but a hill or a hilly region, something like that. Contour deflects uphill at valley lines and downhill at the ridge lines. Okay, contour lines generally are going to be U-shaped. I'll be showing you that typical contour map. What is it referring to, this particular point? Okay, so contour lines in U shape cross what is called as a ridge line, and V shaped cross what is called as valley lines at not ridge angles, it is right angles. Please do understand the corrections, whatever I am representing. Okay, so the valley line and a ridge line are going to be intersecting each other at right angles. Contour lines meeting at a point indicate what is called as a vertical cliff. Earlier we said two contour lines will not intersect at all, but however, in some particular case, I repeat, in some particular case, whenever you are looking at a contour map, you might be understanding that two contour lines are intersecting each other, but however, they are not exactly intersecting each other. What they are going to be indicating you is what I'll just try to make it very clear. Contour lines cannot cross one another except in the case of an overhanging cliff. So whenever you have what is called as an overhanging cliff, what does this overhanging cliff means? I'll just try to tell you. Okay. So except in the case of what is called as an overhanging cliff, you will not come across with a situation where the represented contour lines will be crossing each other. As if one is intersecting each other, you will be seeing those represented contour lines. But however, in one case, you will be indicating one contour line crossing over the other contour line. One contour line is going to be indicated with what is called as a dotted line, whereas the other contour line is going to be indicated by your dark line. Okay, so it's a solid line, whereas one will be indicated by a dotted line. So such kind of representation of where two contour lines are seen as if they are intersecting each other, where one is represented with a solid line and the other represented with your dotted line, so which indicates that there is a overhanging cliff or overhanging projection of the mountain region, so because of which you get a contour map as if they look like things getting intersected. This is what is your overhanging cliff.